From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
I'm Norm Krakos. The man accused of building several bombs at his home in Alfred, expected in federal court today.
Robert Infante is charged with several crimes, including possession of a destructive device. News 8's Dave Guthrow has more on this story from outside U.S. District Court in Portland.
47-year-old Robert Infante faces a variety of charges stemming from an incident in late June that led to his indictment by a federal grand jury last week. Now, Infante called police from his Alfred home on June 25th to report a propane gas explosion at his house. He told police he had injured his hand filling his butane lighter. He refused ambulance service and actually drove himself to Southern Maine Medical Center in Biddeford. Now, at the hospital, police cordoned off his car and found five pipe bombs back at his house. Federal authorities say they found 12 pipe bombs and more than 100 marijuana plants. Now, Infante has been in and out of federal prison since 1987. In fact, he was convicted on a charge of possession of a destructive device back in 1989. That's the same charge he'll face today, along with other charges for drug and firearm infractions. And we'll, of course, have full coverage of the arraignment on News 8 at 6 and on WMTW.com. For now, in Portland, Dave Guthrow for News 8 Now.
An autopsy is scheduled today on a 22-year-old man who was found shot to death in a Portland apartment.
And police calling his death a homicide, but so far no one has been arrested. Detectives were called to an apartment complex at 55 Allen Avenue around 3:40 Sunday morning after someone called 911 saying a man had been shot. When officers arrived, they found the victim, a 22-year-old man originally from New York City, inside one of the apartments. Medics tried to treat him, but the man, who police have not identified, was pronounced dead at the scene. If you have any information about this case, you're asked to call Portland Police. That number is on your screen.
NSA medical examiner also scheduled to perform an autopsy on the body of Devin Stewart, a 17-year-old from Warren who died while swimming in Lincolnville over the weekend. Authorities say Stewart was swimming with three friends Friday night off Fernald Neck Preserve, that's on Beguntacook Lake. They say he disappeared while swimming, and search crews, they worked into the night looking for him. Police say Stewart's body was located Saturday morning, not far from the spot where his friends last saw him.
Officials in Paris will hold a town meeting tonight to discuss a proposed 180-day moratorium on medical marijuana. The proposal says marijuana dispensaries present new concerns, including that of public safety. It also says the town needs time to develop reasonable ways to regulate the location and operation of a dispensary. Since voters approved medical marijuana dispensaries back in November, cities and towns across the state have proposed moratoriums to allow officials more time to set up the new regulations for them. Tonight's meeting in Paris will begin at 7 at the fire station.
Cumberland County Sheriff Mark Dion picked out the Democratic nomination for House District 113. District 113 represents the North Deering area of Portland, also the western part of Falmouth. Republicans are expected to choose their nominee soon. Their candidate, Charlie Burns, dropped out of the race last month.
And that's it for this update. I'm Norm Krakos.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. We'll bring the latest forecast and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.